Okay, so in this video, we're going to take a look at some questions involving substitution. So this involves taking expressions or equations and swapping the individual terms for given values. So for this first example, we can see we've got find the value of 3a plus 2b when a is equal to 5 and b is equal to 3. So when we substitute, all we need to do is swap. I'm going to swap that a for 5 and I'm going to swap that term of b for 3. So when we're substituting and we've got a multiplication involved, like this 3 times A and 2 times B, it can be handy to put the number we're substituting in a bracket. So to begin with, we're starting with this expression 3A plus 2B. So I'm going to swap the A for a 5, and as I do that, I'm going to put it in a bracket like so. And then I'm going to do the same for the B, but because B is equal to 3, I'm going to swap B for 3, and I'm going to put that in a bracket as well. And doing it this way with the brackets can be extremely useful, especially if we're allowed to use a calculator, because all we need to do is type it in as we see. So we've got 3 multiplied by the 5, we're then adding this 2 multiplied by 3. So we've typed it in exactly how we've seen it. We hit equals, that gives us 21. So by using these brackets, we're making sure that we're applying the rules of the orders of operation. But again, we might not have the calculator in this case. So what we would do now is simplify. So we've got 3 times 5, well, that would give us 15. So that simplifies to 15. We've then got that 2 times 3, which gives us 6. Then all we have to do is 15 plus 6, which gives us 21. So the value of the expression 3a plus 2b would actually be 21. So let's take a look at another example. In this next question, we've got v is equal to u plus at. We want to find the value of v when u is equal to 4, a is equal to 9, and t is equal to 5. So what I'm going to do to start with is just bring this equation down, and then we can start substituting into it. So we're finding the value of v, so that's going to remain as v. So the first thing I'm going to do is substitute the value for u, which is 4, but because that's on its own, we don't really need a bracket here, so I can just swap the u. 4. I'm then going to substitute the a, which is equal to 9, but in the equation we can see we're multiplying a by t, so I'm going to put this in a bracket. So where a was originally, I'm now going to swap that for a 9 in brackets, and I'm going to do exactly the same for t. T was equal to 5, so I'm going to substitute that in brackets. So we've now got v is equal to 4 plus 9 multiplied by 5. So following our order of operations, we're going to do the 9 multiplied by 5 first. Well, that would give us 45. We then simply just need to add these two numbers together. So 4 plus 45 would give us 49. Again, if we just go back to the earlier stage where we were calculating this, if we had the calculator, we could type this in just as we see it. So we'd have 4 plus, and then in brackets 9, and then in another bracket 5. So then when we hit equals, we get to our answer that we had before, which was 49. So again, this just shows how useful those brackets are. So hopefully those few worked examples made sense. We're now going to take a look at some practice questions. So feel free to pause the video here and have a go at these, and we'll go through the solutions in just a few moments. So for this first example, we've got d is equal to 5e take away 4. We then want to find the value of d when e is equal to 7. So all I'm going to do here is swap the e for 7, but because in the equation I'm multiplying it by 5, I'm going to put it in a bracket. So we'd have d is equal to 5, and then our bracket 7 take away 4. So then following our order of operations, we're going to do the 5 times 7 first. Well, that's going to give us 35, and then I've still got this take away 4. So then to finish off, we've just got to do 35 take away 4, which is 31. So here we'd have d is equal to 31. Okay, moving on, we've got l is equal to 12m plus 3n. So we want to find the value of l when m is equal to 2 and n is equal to negative 5. So again, all we're going to do is write this out again. So we've got L is equal to 12 times M. Well, we know M is equal to 2, so I'm going to substitute that in a bracket. So that 2 would go there, plus 3 lots of N, Well, n is negative 5, so I'm going to substitute that in a bracket. So now all we're going to do is work our way through and simplify. Well, we've got 12 times 2, which is 24. And then we've got positive 3 times negative 5. Well, that's going to give us negative 15, because a positive and a negative make a negative, and then 3 times 5 is 15. So we've got 24 take away 15. And if we do that, we're left with 9. So to finish this one off, we just have L is equal to 9. Okay, for this next question, we've got P is equal to Q, and then in brackets, R minus 5. We want to find the value of P when Q is equal to 7 and R is equal to 8. So again, all we're going to do is rewrite this and substitute in the values that we've been told. So we're going to have that P is equal to, well, because Q's all on its own here, I can just put the 7 in on its own. I could put it in a bracket, but because it's on its own, I'm just going to write a 7. Then I've got this open bracket, R, which in this case is 8, take away 5. So now all we need to do is follow our order of operations. So we're going to simplify the bracket first. So we've got 8 take away 5. Well, that is 3. So that's going to leave us with 7, then 3 in the bracket. So we've got to do 7 multiplied by 3, which is 21. So our answer here would be P is equal to 21. Okay, moving on. For this next question, we've got A is equal to 4BC. We want to find the value of A when B is equal to negative 3 and C is equal to negative 5. So again, we're just going to rewrite this and substitute as we go. So A is going to be equal to 4. And then because we're multiplying these terms together, we're going to put them in brackets. So instead of B, we're going to use negative 3. And then instead of C, we're going to use negative 5. So now we just need to simplify as we go. So we're multiplying all these numbers together. So if I just do the 4 multiplied by negative 3 first, well, I've got a positive times a negative. That's going to give me a negative. And then the 4 times 3 gives us 12. So that would be negative 12, which we then still need to multiply by this negative 5. Well, we've got a negative times a negative, which would give us a positive. And then 12 times 5 is 60. So A would actually be equal to positive 60. And again, if we were given the calculator for this particular question, we can see again why using these brackets are extremely useful. Because if I type in that top line of that equation, we had 4, then open bracket, negative 3, new bracket, negative 5, equals 60. So we know we've got the correct answer there. Okay, and for this very last question, we've got x is equal to 4y squared, take away 10. We want to find the value of x when y is equal to 3. So again, we're going to substitute y in. We're actually raising it to the power of 2 and then multiplying it by 4. So we're going to include a bracket again this time. So rewriting this, we've got x is equal to 4. And then instead of the y, I'm going to put a 3 in that bracket, which then I need to square. And then I'm going to take away 10. So again, following our order of operations, we're going to square that 3 first, so we're going to have 4 times 3 squared is 9, so we have a 9 there. We're then going to multiply the 4 and the 9 together. Well, 4 times 9 is 36, so that would change to 36. And then finally, all we need to do is 36 take away 10. So for our final answer, we'd have x is equal to 26. And again, if we had the calculator, we can check our answer here. So if we type it in again, exactly the same as we wrote it down at the beginning, we'd have 4 open bracket 3 close bracket squared take away 10. So again, because we've put the brackets in the correct place, the calculator will take care of the order of operations for us. So when we hit equals, we get 26. So we know we've got that one correct as well. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for this video. If you want to check out any of my other algebra videos, then I've left a link for my algebra playlist in the description, and I've also put a card in the top corner, so feel free to check them out. Well, I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.